Hi guys, very good morning. Today I started the MATLAB. So this is the Linux system. So I can search MATLAB icon. So this is the MATLAB icon. So I am using R2019A. So this is the latest version 2019 year. So this is the trial version. So you can download it the Google and install Linux command window. So this is our MATLAB. So first, what is the MATLAB? So MATLAB means Matrix Laboratory. So Matrix Laboratory means each and every information stored in some MNTN matrix. So I can share the MATLAB introduction part. So this is the MATLAB. MATLAB means Matrix Laboratory, or combination of rows and columns information. So introduction of the MATLAB. So MATLAB is a fourth generation high level language. So when compared to other languages, MATLAB is easy to interface with other languages and easy to write the coding. And MATLAB information is stored in only matrix formatry. Matrix formatry means it will be rows into columns. Okay, so and here every matrix consists of M and N columns. It represents M into N. So any information like image, speech, video, and mathematical equations and scientific equations, like whatever information, will be stored in matrix format only. And next, so here we can use mathematical functions and plotting and calculations and performing various vector quantizations and integrations. So whatever information we will write very easily. So next, what is the history? So history means, so when we started the MATLAB, and what is the company name, who are the basic founders. So this information. So MATLAB is developed by MathWorks company. So here we will see the company name. So MATLAB R2019A. So this is the MathWorks company. And next, in late 1970s, Clive Molar and Steve Benjet. So these two scientists are basic founders in MATLAB. So Clive Molar and Steve Benjet, so those are the New Mexico in CSE department. And next, the first MATLAB will be implemented Fortran language. So that is the first language. In late 1970s, we are using Fortran language. So the next C, so the next Java, .NET and MATLAB. So right now we are using Python. So this is the advanced language. And next, in those days we are using Fortran language. And finally, in 1983, the Fortran language is rewritten with C language. Okay, so in the third point, in 1984, the Fortran language with C will be rewriting MathWorks company to launch the MATLAB with C syntaxes. Okay, so in 1984 onwards, we are using MATLAB toolbox or MATLAB with C language. And MATLAB have 72 plus toolboxes is there. So for example, so I am the electronics department. I am using digital image processing toolbox. Okay, and digital signal processing toolbox, and digital communication toolbox. For example, electrical users. So electrical users, they are using Simulink toolbox. Simulink toolbox have power systems and power electronics. So those toolboxes are used in EEE users, okay, electrical users. And for example, mechanical students. Mechanical students, they are using mechatronics tool. And for example, MBBS doctors. So those users used in biomedical tool. So these are the different tools are available in our MATLAB tool. And next, so for example, MATLAB is every year to release two versions. Two versions means R2019A and R2019B. So what is the difference of R2019A and R2019B? So R2019A is the first version, like January to June. And R2019A 19B means July to December. So what is the difference? So the difference is to updated the new commands, updated the new toolboxes, and updated the whatever we are using our latest technology. The information will be rewrite in advanced versions. Okay. And next. So what is the power of computational mathematics by using MATLAB? So MATLAB is used in every facet of computational mathematics, like scientifical equation and mathematical equation, following some commonly used mathematical calculation with dealing with matrices and arrays and 2D and 3D plotting and graphics and linear algebra and whatever shortcuts of the mathematical equations. And next, nonlinear functions and linear functions and statistics and data analysis and calculate the different equations. What is the futures of MATLAB? So futures of MATLAB means it is a high level language when compared to other languages like visual applications and computer vision applications. So this applications is very easy to implement the our MATLAB tool and easy to interface with Java, C++, embedded system hardware. Okay, so embedded hardware system means it will be 8051 microcontroller and Arduino and ARM and Raspberry Pi, Beagle Blackbone. So these are the hardware parts. That particular hardware package is available in our MATLAB tool. So that is easy to interface with other languages and less complexity, means low complexity. So whatever we write the coding, it will be length of coding is very less when compared to other technologies and user friendly. So what is the meaning of user friendly? So user friendly means, for example, I can write the 100 lines of coding. In 70 line, I got error. MATLAB shows the 70 line, what is the error and what type of error will be coming, like syntax errors and variable errors and calculation errors, whatever error, MATLAB is show the that particular information. And the main thing is, in other languages like C, Java, C++ and Python, so these languages have header files. Header files means, for example, I can write the addition of two variables, for example, A equals to 10, B equals to 10 and C equals to A plus B. The same information I can write the C language, I can included hash include studio.h, that is the header file. Without header file, we cannot run the that particular file in C and other language Java C++. But in MATLAB have there is no header files. Okay, so we can write directly. So that is the main advantages in MATLAB and uses of MATLAB. So as a MATLAB users, signal processing and communication, and image and video processing, test and measurement applications, and computational finance applications, and computational biology applications. So image processing applications and signal processing applications and digital communication like antennas and satellite communication and OFDM technology and multi-input multi-output technology and mm wave communication and millimeter wave communication. So whatever communication wise application, we can very easy to interface and easy to write the coding. So that is the uses of MATLAB. Next, so I can show the MATLAB R2019A. So this is the latest version R2019A. So this is the command window. So here we can write, here we can show the software. This is the command window and this is the workspace and this is the details like history of the files and this is the new script. So this is the current folder. So we have mainly five windows. One is the command window and second one is the workspace and third one is the current folder and fourth one is the history and fifth one is the new script. So how to use command window and what is the uses of workspace and what is the uses of current folder and what is the history of the files, I can show. For example, in command window, whatever error will be showing command window and like it will be single time execution. For example, I can write A equals to 100. So this is the variable and B equals to 200 and C equals to A plus B. We can write directly. So C is 300. So I cannot edit the A value here, not available. Okay, means it will be single time execution. Okay, and next workspace. So workspace means whatever we can write the variables data. For example, A equals to 100 and B equals to 200 and what is our output value, C equals to 300. So the total variables data will be stored in workspace. Okay, and current folder means, so I can open the direct MATLAB. This is the C drive. So I can write the my file in desktop, whatever desktop files will be shown in current folder. And this is the new script. New script means editing option is there and to increase the length of coding. So everything will be written in editor window only. So this is the software introduction. Okay, thank you. And next, so whatever if you need any applications like any information in MATLAB, so please comment in below of the video. I can share this video in YouTube.